Hi, welcome. Today I am going to start a lecture series for the FY BSc students. Subject is CH101 Physical Chemistry, which is of a 2-credit course. And the chapter is Chemical Energetics. So let us start with first lecture. So first point is thermodynamics. So in thermodynamics, we know that the thermo means heat and dynamics means motion or mechanical work. So when we get these two words, thermo and dynamics, together, then we get a word, thermodynamics. So what is thermodynamics? The branch of science which deals with the conversion of heat into mechanical work and vice versa. What is thermodynamics? The branch of science which deals with the conversion of heat into mechanical work or vice versa. Now, we will define what is thermodynamics or what is the actual definition of thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is a branch of science that deals with quantitative relationships between heat and other forms of energy. So, in the previous slide, we have seen that there is a conversion of heat into mechanical work or conversion of mechanical work into heat. Now, we have added two words, quantitative and relationship, in the definition. So, thermodynamics is a branch of science that deals with quantitative relationships between heat and other forms of energy. So, when heat is converted into another form, how much quantity of heat is converted? Or from another form of energy, if there is a formation of a heat, then how much heat is produced? So the quantity is important. So when you write the definition of thermodynamics, there you have to include the word quantitative relationship. So the actual definition of thermodynamics is, thermodynamics is a branch of science that deals with quantitative relationships between heat and other forms of energy. So don't forget to write the word quantitative and relationships. Now, study of thermodynamics is based on three laws. You know it very well that first law, second law and third law of thermodynamics. All the study of thermodynamics is based on these three laws. Now, what are the objectives of thermodynamics? So, when we are going to study thermodynamics, we should know what are our objectives. So, there are total three objectives. The very first objective is to predict the feasibility of a process. Now, what is mean by feasibility? Feasibility means whether or not a process will occur under the given set of conditions. So, thermodynamics help us to predict the feasibility of a process, that is whether or not a process will occur under the given set of conditions. Second objective is to estimate the yield of the products. Now see, thermodynamic relations help to predict the yield of the products obtainable in a process or a reaction. Okay, so whenever we carry out any reaction, what will be the yield of product of that reaction, we can predict with the help of a thermodynamic relation. Okay, and third objective is to deduce some important relationships. So it has been possible to deduce some important and useful result, such as Raoult's law, then a lowering of vapor pressure, then depression in freezing point, elevation in boiling point, distribution law, phase rule, etc. from the study of thermodynamics. So, there are total three objectives of thermodynamics. Now, there are some limitations of thermodynamics. So, when we start to study thermodynamics, we should know what are the limitations of thermodynamics. So initially we have seen objectives of thermodynamics, but वी शुड ऑल्सो नो व्हाट आर दी लिमिटेशंस ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. सो द फर्स्ट लिमिटेशन इज इट डील्स विद द प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक टेम्परेचर प्रेशर एट्सेट्रा ऑफ द मैटर इन बल्क और मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज एंड नॉट इन माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज. सो इन सिंपल वर्ड द थर्मोडायनेमिक गिव्स अस एक्सप्लेनेशन अबाउट द मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज एंड नॉट अबाउट माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज. सी इन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स इन 12th स्टैंडर्ड यू हैव कंसिडर्ड ए सिलिंडर फिटेड विथ ए पिस्टन, ए गैस सिलिंडर फिटेड विथ ए पिस्टन. सो दैट गैस सिलिंडर इज ए मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी, इट इज नॉट अ माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी. सो व्हाट आर द माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज? सी सपोज व्हेन वी कंसिडर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ प्रोटॉन, न्यूट्रॉन, इलेक्ट्रॉन एट्सेट्रा. सो दीज प्रोटॉन, न्यूट्रॉन, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, दीज आर दी माइक्रोस्कोपिक कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स. एंड व्हेन वी स्टडी द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ दैट कंस्टिट्यूएंट देन इट इज ए माइक्रोस्कोपिक स्टडी. बट व्हेन वी कंसिडर ए गैस सिलिंडर, दैट गैस सिलिंडर इज ए मैक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल. एंड व्हेन वी स्टडी इट्स प्रॉपर्टी देन इट इज ए मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी. सो व्हाट थर्मोडायनेमिक्स गिव्स अस? इट गिव्स अस और इट स्टडीज प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक टेम्परेचर, प्रेशर एट्सेट्रा ऑफ द मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज एंड नॉट ऑफ द माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट लिमिटेशन ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. सेकेंड लिमिटेशन इज इट हेल्प्स टू प्रिडिक्ट द फिजिबिलिटी ऑफ ए प्रोसेस बट गिव्स नो आइडिया अबाउट द टाइम टेकन फॉर द प्रोसेस टू कंप्लीट और द रेट एट विच द प्रोसेस वुड प्रोसीड. सो इन द इनिशियल स्लाइड वी हैव सीन दैट थर्मोडायनेमिक गिव्स अस टू प्रिडिक्ट द फिजिबिलिटी ऑफ ए प्रोसेस वेदर द रिएक्शन टेक प्लेस और नॉट, बट इट डज नॉट गिव एनी आइडिया अबाउट द टाइम. हाउ मच टाइम विल रिक्वायर टू कंप्लीट ए प्रोसेस और ए रिएक्शन इट कैनॉट टेल, इट कैनॉट गिवन बाय द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. इट ओनली गिव्स अस वेदर रिएक्शन टेक प्लेस और नॉट एंड इट टेल्स नथिंग अबाउट द टाइम टेकन फॉर द प्रोसेस टू कंप्लीट. दिस इज द सेकेंड लिमिटेशन ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. एंड द लास्ट लिमिटेशन ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स इज इट्स ट्रीटमेंट इज लिमिटेड टू द इनिशियल एंड फाइनल स्टेट्स ऑफ ए सिस्टम एंड इट्स साइलेंट अबाउट द पाथ. द वर्ड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, द पाथ बाय विच द चेंज इज ब्राउट अबाउट, दैट इज इट डज नॉट रिवील द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ए प्रोसेस. सो थर्मोडायनेमिक्स इज रिलेटेड टू ओनली इनिशियल स्टेट एंड फाइनल स्टेट ऑफ ए सिस्टम. ओके सपोज इफ यू हैव ए वॉटर, इफ यू टेक कोल्ड वॉटर देन इट्स इनिशियल कंडीशन इज इट इज कोल्ड एंड व्हेन वी हीट इट इट बिकम हॉट. सो फाइनल कंडीशन इज इट इज हॉट. सो इनिशियली इट वॉज कोल्ड, फाइनली इट इज हॉट. सो इनिशियल एंड फाइनल स्टेट. सो व्हेन वी बॉइल दैट वॉटर एंड इफ वी अप्लाय द थर्मोडायनेमिक कंसिडरेशन टू इट देन द थर्मोडायनेमिक ट्रीटमेंट इज लिमिटेड टू द इनिशियल एंड फाइनल स्टेट ऑफ दैट सिस्टम एंड इट इज साइलेंट अबाउट द पाथ बाय विच द चेंज इज ब्राउट अबाउट, दैट इज इट डज नॉट रिवील द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ए प्रोसेस. सो देयर आर टोटल थ्री लिमिटेशंस ऑफ द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. सी दिस फिगर, इन दिस फिगर सी दिस सिस्टम ए इज इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विद सिस्टम सी. ओके एंड सिस्टम बी इज इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विद सिस्टम सी. सो दैट सिस्टम ए एंड बी आर ऑल्सो इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विद ईच अदर. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ दिस लॉ? इफ टू बॉडीज ए एंड बी आर इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विथ अनदर बॉडी सी देन ए एंड बी विल ऑल्सो इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विथ ईच अदर. सो इन दिस फिगर दिस इज क्लियरली एक्सप्लेन दैट सिस्टम ए इनिशियली इज इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विथ सिस्टम सी then system B is also in thermal equilibrium with system C. So the system A and system B are in thermal equilibrium of each other. Okay, this is very important law, zeroth law of thermodynamics. Now we have to study statements of first law of thermodynamics. So there are various statements or first law of thermodynamics can be stated in a number of ways. Some statements of this law are as follows. First statement is very famous statement, energy can neither be created nor destroyed, although it may be converted from one form to another. So this statement does not require any explanation, because we are studying this statement from our 7th or 8th standard, that energy can neither be created nor destroyed, although it may be converted from one form to another. So it is a very simple statement of the first law of thermodynamics. Second statement is, the total energy of an isolated system remains constant, although it may undergo transformation from one form to the other. See, one form of energy is get transformed into another form of energy. Okay, that another form again get converted into the next another form. During that process, the total energy of an isolated system remains constant. So energy remains constant. This is the second statement of first law of thermodynamics. You have to keep in mind all these statements. Third statement, whenever certain quantity of some form of energy disappear, an exactly equivalent amount of some other form of energy must be produced. So in one form, if some energy is disappeared, in another exactly equivalent amount is produced. This is the third statement. And fourth statement is, it is impossible to construct a perpetual motion machine. So what is mean by perpetual motion machine? That is a machine which will produce work continuously without consuming energy. So it is impossible to construct that machine. See, suppose if we have a machine which is working continuously and it does not consume any energy. Okay, so this cannot be happen. This cannot be reality. We can only assume that we have a machine which is working continuously and it does not consume energy. This is very ideal situation, and in reality this cannot be happen. So such a type of machine is called as a perpetual motion machine, and it is impossible to construct. We cannot construct such a type of machine which is working continuously and it does not require any energy. So these four are the statements of first law of thermodynamics. In your university examination, they can ask a question, write the statements of first law of thermodynamics. Then you have to write these four statements of first law of thermodynamics. Now, next point is law of conservation of mass and energy. We all know that Einstein in 1905 showed that the energy could be created by the destruction of mass. In 1905, Einstein showed that the energy could be created by the destruction of mass, and the energy produced E by the destruction of mass M is given by the very famous equation E is equal to mc square, where E is energy, M is mass, and C is the speed of light or velocity of light. So in the light of this idea, the law of conservation of energy has been modified. The first law of the first statement of first law of thermodynamics was energy can neither be created nor destroyed, although it may be converted from one form to another. It was or it is nothing but the law of conservation of energy. But as Einstein given us equation E is equal to mc square, in the light of this idea, the law of conservation of energy has been modified and now it is called law of conservation of mass and energy. And it can be stated as the statement of this law: the total mass and the energy of an isolated system remains constant. So not only the energy but mass also. So what is the statement of law of conservation of mass and energy? The total mass and the energy of an isolated system remains constant. Okay, so this is about the some facts of the thermodynamics in today's lecture. We have seen what is meant by thermodynamics, then definition of thermodynamics, then what are the objectives of thermodynamics. There are three objectives. Then what are the limitations of thermodynamics? There are three limitations. Then we have seen zeroth law of thermodynamics. Then we have seen four statements of the first law of thermodynamics. And lastly, we have seen law of conservation of mass and energy. Thank you.